Hi, in today's video we are going to show you how to call a Power Automate flow from Power Apps. We will show you how to pass some parameters to run the flow and how to receive the outputs from Power Automate. We'll try to keep it simple and short, so let's go. We have here our blank app, and we are creating here an app that's going to call a Power Automate to send an email for us. So let's begin inserting here some labels and some text inputs. So this will be the to. Who are we sending the email to? So here, text input. Let's insert a new label here. That will be the email subject. Subject. Okay. And let's insert a new text input here. And now we are inserting a button, and let's call it send email. Okay. Great, now we select the button and we go to action here at the top of the screen and we choose Power Automate. So Power Apps is showing here to us the flows that are already created in our environment here, but let's create a new one. So here Power Automate offers us a variety of flows that we can use as templates to have a kickstart, but we will use the simplest one for today. So it's just a trigger from Power Apps. Now we're going to add a new action here. Let's initialize a variable. Okay, let's call it body. This is going to be our email body. It's going to be a fixed text. And in the future, if we want to change it, we just come here to the flow and change it this initial step. So, okay. Now we search for an email action. So let's use this one from Outlook, send an email. Great. And here, if we come here in the to, we have to specify who are we sending the email to. And this content here, we are grabbing from Power Apps. We come here to the add dynamic content, and here we have this option, asking Power Apps. This is showing here because we have a trigger from Power Apps. So we can choose it. And then automatically, when we call this Power Automate flow from Power Apps, we will have to specify this value. And we can go here to the subject as well. And we can add another variable. So if we click here and see more, we can ask in Power Apps. And then it's our second input parameter. And we can do this how many times we need to. In the body, we are going to use the body that we have defined here. Okay. And let's just to show off how can we have some outputs here. This is going to be very simple, but I think we can show this way. So respond, let's type here Power Apps. So we have this command here, respond to a Power App or flow. And we can, this will be the output command. We can add how many outputs we want. Let's just add one output called body. That will be our fixed variable, right? That we have defined here. So it's body. Okay, let's hit save. And this is our flow. So we pass as parameters the who are we sending the email to, the subject of the email, and that's it. And we receive the body that it's initialized here. So, okay, we have created our flow. Now we go back to the Power Apps, and here it is, Power Apps button. We could rename it, but let's keep it simple. Let's do it. Just select it. And here, it's saying to us the parameters it needs to run. So let's use the run this text input one here. So it will grab from text input one dot text, and the subject it will grab from text input two. Input two. Okay, and that's it. So. But what we're doing here, let's run it and then I explain to you. So here we are logged in as our user, our test user Mozart, and let's send an email to Bach. That's another test user we have. So we have Mozart and we have Bach. Okay, subject one. Let's do it. So let's send email. And here in another browser screen, we have mailbox of Bach opened, and there we go. We have already received the email from Mozart, and that's it, simple as that. And how can we use the output parameter from the flow? So we call the Power Automate flow from Power Apps, but we received an output that it's the body, right? Do you remember? Here, the last step here. So if we go to the function, that's the action that's calling the button, we have it returns the value of the flow output. So we just have to specify here, let's say it's the output, and let's store it in a variable, in a global variable, okay? And now let's insert a label here in the end, saying that we want to show the output dot body. That's the name we have typed in our flow. So, okay, now let's send mail, and we got our body when we hit send mail. Great, right? So that's it for today. I hope you like our episode, and see you next time.